5:30, preparing for the worst-case scenario.
Earlier today, the city of Providence put a new chemical detector sensor system in the Port of Providence to the test. And we've learned that new system should help first responders if an emergency happens.
Eyewitness News reporter Nathan Rosu joins us now with more on our top local story from the Providence Mobile Newsroom.
Funded by a $563,000 federal Homeland Security grant, the new system is expected to improve emergency response times when just a few seconds can make a difference. An online video shows what it would look like if a train and truck crash near Allen's Avenue in Providence. Chemicals from the truck spill, creating a cloud of smoke. This new chemical detection sensor goes off, and the first responders are notified.
These detectors will provide our emergency response personnel with critical information needed to accurately evaluate potential threats and mobilize quickly to protect the residents of our city and state.
With the help of federal funds, a network of chemical sensors now exists from the southern entrance of Narragansett Bay to the Port of Providence.
Providence depends on the free flow of seaborne trade. The Port of Providence serves as a major oil and gas hub for Rhode Island and southeast New England, so it's crucial that we protect this piece of critical infrastructure.
Though the sensors are not able to detect certain chemicals like petroleum, the system is able to identify 15 different toxic materials and 7 chemical warfare agents.
This is state-of-the-art technology which is developed right here in Rhode Island, the new chemical detectors, as they will strengthen our preparedness in the Port of Providence.
Eventually, the new chemical detectors will be linked into the port emergency siren warning system, which emits a loud alert and also sends voice messages to residents, businesses, and people who might be visiting the port area in the case of an emergency. With the Providence Mobile Newsroom, I'm Naka Nwosu, Eyewitness News.